We are back for another video, and basically in this one, I'm gonna be trying like a post-commentary sort of style, just to like try it out. Basically I have like I think it's like 5 to 6 matches in this video. Basically I'm gonna commentate over like the best ones, so like probably over like 3. But like the rest of the matches will be in the video if you want to see that as well. But basically like I just want to try out this like form of commentary just to see if it works out. If it doesn't, I'll just like switch back to live com. But I think this should work well for the most part, I think, but I guess we'll see. Anyway though, we are looking at Galarian Moltres today. Galarian Moltres is very, very good. You don't see it enough. Galarian Moltres is very good. It's a very basic Pokemon. Like, it doesn't have a lot of utility to it. Like, it's just like a basic damage dealer, but it does its role very well. Okay, so basically, as Berserk, what Berserk basically does is when Galarian Moltres falls below 50% HP or is at exactly 50% HP, it basically gets a special attack increase, okay? Essentially, what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be abusing Berserk. We're going to be abusing Berserk to its maximum, like, capacity. Okay, so essentially, what's going to happen, okay, is Galarian Moltres has the Citrus Berry. So when it falls below 50% HP, obviously Berserk will proc. It'll get a special attack increase. Again, it does have the Citrus Berry, so essentially it'll go back up to basically like green HP from yellow. And Berserk can actually proc multiple times during the match. So when Galarian Moltres goes back into the yellow, Berserk will proc again. And essentially Galarian Moltres will basically be at +2 special attack. We also have Sinistra. So when Galarian Moltres is in the yellow for the second time during the match, okay, we send out Sinistra. Hospitality essentially makes it so Galarian Moltres goes back into the green, and if Galarian Moltres goes back into the yellow again, Berserk will proc for the third time, and essentially Galarian Moltres will be at +3 special attack. This strategy is so stupid because like it's Moltres is basically passively gaining special attack increases by doing nothing. Literally just by existing, Galarian Moltres is getting stronger. And on top of that, okay, first turn, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be using Nasty Plot. So essentially, if everything goes well, Galarian Moltres will basically be a +5 special attack. And what makes it even better as well is Galarian Moltres basically has access to a better Dazzling Gleam in Fiery Wrath. I call Fiery Wrath a better Dazzling Gleam because essentially Fiery Wrath hits both opponents. But Fiery Wrath has more base power, so Dazzling Gleam has 80, Fiery Wrath has 90. So Moltres is basically just cooking. Like he is cooking. I made a Terra Poison because Flutterman is basically everywhere. Obviously, like Galarian Moltres is a dark type and dark is weak to fairy. Poison resists fairy, so there you go. In the matches, I do send out Talonflame along with Moltres, basically just for Tailwind. I could use Tornadus, but I chose Talonflame on purpose because Talonflame doesn't have Prankster. Okay, look, let me explain, okay? When you have Prankster, you can't taunt other Dark-type Pokemon. So, like, if you're fighting Grimmsnarl, or if you're fighting, like, other Pokemon that just Terra into Terra Dark, you can't taunt them because that's basically how Prankster works. You can't use Prankster against Dark-type Pokemon. Talonflame doesn't have Prankster. So, Talonflame can basically, like, taunt whoever the hell wants to taunt. The second thing is Prankster taunt doesn't work on the Psychic terrain. So, if you're fighting in DD, essentially, you can't taunt it because of Psychic Terrain. Talonflame doesn't have Prankster. So Talonflame can essentially taunt in DD and basically shut it down that way. Tornadus can't really do that. And Talonflame does have access to Will-O-Wisp, which is a very, very good move, as you know. And in this video, Will-O-Wisp actually does come in useful in quite a few matches. So yeah, Talonflame definitely still has value in Reg E. Even though you don't really see it a lot, it's still definitely very good. And even though it doesn't have Prankster, it does have Gale Wings, which isn't the same as Prankster. I mean, like, it basically was kind of in Gen 6. Like, it gave priority to, like, Flying-type moves. Now it only does that if you're at full HP. But essentially, Talonflame's only, like, role in the matches is basically just to use Tailwind first turn. And that's basically it. Like, after that, Talonflame's done its job. Like, it can go down. Basically, I'm only using it just for Tailwind. And that's basically it. So yeah, before we get into the matches, I want to go over Sinistra as well, because Sinistra is a key component in the team. Essentially, Sinistra has the Rocky Helmet, it has Rage Powder, so essentially when Sinistra is out with Galarian Moltres, I'll just be spamming Rage Powder while Moltres basically spams Fiery Wrath. And yeah, that's basically it. The EVs for the team will be in the description. And let's get into the matches. Okay, first match. Over here, our opponent sent out, Landorus and Golden Go. So with Tenor Flame over here, I think we just use Tailwind. And I think, yeah, I Terra first turn. So I Terra Moltres into Terra Poison because Landorus is basically going to use Rot Slide. And I didn't want to take too much damage like in the first turn, even though obviously we want Moltres to be in the yellow so Berserk can activate. I basically wanted to try and preserve it, and I didn't want it to happen so early on in the match. So yeah, over here we Terra Moltres into Terra Poison. Gordon uses Protect, which is like absolutely fine, obviously. We use Tailwind here, and Moltres uses Nasty Plot. Okay. Yeah, obviously Landorus uses Rot Slide. Talonflame actually avoids the attack, which is very lucky. And it does get a crit onto Moltres. We do take a decent amount of damage, but obviously we aren't in the range where Berserk procs. Over here with Talonflame, I think I use Will-O-Wisp onto Landorus. No, Heat Wave. Oh yeah, Heat Wave because Gordon is obviously weak to fire. And then I just use Fiery Wrath just because we're plus 2 special attack now, so like, why not, basically. They swap out Golden Go here, and then they go into Iron Hands. Heat Wave does a decent amount of damage to Landorus, and it does get burnt, but it doesn't really matter too much because Fiery Wrath basically just takes care of Landorus from here. Yeah. Iron Hands didn't take too much damage, probably has the Assault Vest, and obviously it was resisted. They go back into Golden Go here, which is fine. Yeah, over here we use Will-O-Wisp onto Iron Hands just to hinder it. And we use, I think, Fiery Wrath here. Do I use Fiery Wrath? No, I use Nasty Plot. Okay. I feel like I should have used Fiery Wrath. I don't know. Looking back on it, I don't think I should have got that greedy. But anyway, they do Terra. I'm going to go into Terra Steel. At this point, okay, I'm saying to myself, if they use Make It Rain, will I go down? Probably. Probably, like... Talonflame probably survives, but Moltres probably goes down. So I'm just hoping that doesn't use Make It Rain. And for some reason, they use Shadow Ball. When again, I'm pretty sure Make It Rain would have probably like gone with Moltres, but I'm not complaining, Berserk activates, the Citrus Berry goes off, so now we're back into the yellow essentially. And I think at this point, I swap out Talonflame into Sinistra. Yeah, obviously because Sinistra has Hospitality. And yeah, I think I use Fiery Wrath here. At this point, Moltres is plus 5 special attack. Sinistra comes in and Moltres goes back into the green. Golden Go uses Protect, which is fine. Fiery Wrath does decent damage to Iron Hands. It uses Wild Charge onto Sinistra. Doesn't really do that much damage, obviously because it's resisted and it's burnt. And the Rocky Helmet and the burn does basically chip down Iron Hands into the red, which is good. Over here, we just use Rage Powder, and we just use Fiery Wrath again, essentially. And there's nothing that Golden Go can really do. I mean, like, I say that, but, like, it can use Make It Rain. But for some reason, again, it doesn't use it, and it uses Shadow Ball. I don't know why it's not using Make It Rain. It literally Terra'd into Terra Steel to use Make It Rain. I mean, like, that's what I assume, anyway. I think. I mean, like, apparently not, actually, but they Terra Steeled and didn't use Make It Rain. And like, I'm pretty sure like Make It Rain probably was the win condition there. And they just never did it. So I don't really know what the hell happened there. We go into Como over here. They go into Rillaboom. I mean, from this point, like the match is basically done. We use Kangaroo Soul. We use Fiery Wrath. And like, there's not much the opponent can really do. So yeah, here's Kangaroo Soul. Our stats go up, obviously. Fiery Wrath. Easily one-shots Rillaboom without any hassle. And yeah. Let's get into the next match. Okay, second match. Okay, yeah, this was the neutralizing gas match. So Moltres didn't have Berserk, obviously because of neutralizing gas. And Talonflame didn't have Gale Wings either. I was actually contemplating if I should use Taunt first, turn onto Weezing, or just like Tailwind. But like I was like saying to myself, you know what, let's just go with Tailwind, why not? And then we Terra Moltres into Terra Poison, and then we use Nasty Plot. Because obviously, Fluttermane is a fairy type and we would be weak to Dazzling Gleam. They do Terra Fairy Fluttermane first turn. Obviously, we Terra Poison here and they do Dazzling Gleam. It actually does a decent amount to Talonflame. Like, that is a lot. Considering that that's resisted, that's a lot of damage. Moltres basically takes nothing from that. We do use Tailwind and Moltres does get off Nasty Plot. Weezing uses Gong Shot, does a decent amount of damage to Moltres. Over here we just use heat wave, and I think I just use air slash onto Fluttermane, just because I didn't think that fire wrath would actually kill, because obviously fairy is resistant to dark. So yeah, heat wave there does decent damage, and air slash does get rid of Fluttermane there. Weezing does use haze, which is a bit annoying, but it definitely isn't a deal breaker. They go into Iron Hands here, and yeah, I basically like immediately use Will-O-Wisp onto it just to hinder it. A nice nasty plot again, just because Weezing did use haze before. Iron Hands does use fake onto Moltres, but Berserk doesn't proc because Weezing does have neutralizing gas. So yeah, Will-O-Wisp doesn't miss, which is really good for us. Weezing uses Gong Shot and Tiny Flame goes down, but that's fine. Here we go into Komo-O, and I think we use Kangaroo's Soul here. Yeah, Kangaroo's Soul. And nasty plot again with Moltres. Yeah, okay, yeah. At this point, there isn't really much my opponent can actually do. Like, they can use haze, sure, but I can just set up again. Iron Hands is basically like a non-factor because it's burn and it isn't doing any damage. So, yeah. We use Kangaroo's Soul, our stats go up. We use Nasty Plot with Moltres, our special attack goes up by 2 stages. Iron Hands uses Drain Punch, and it does no damage. It does actually no damage. Weezing doesn't use Haze, and it uses Gong Shot onto Komo-O. Tailwind's actually gone, but it doesn't really matter. We use Clanging Scales here. I think here we just use Fire Wrath as well. They actually swap out Iron Hands, and they go into Ogre Pond here. Weezing uses Protect, which is fine. Clang Scale is basically like one shots Ogre Pond. Like, that's like what, like 2 HP left. Fire Wrath gets rid of Ogre Pond, and that's basically it. They go back into Iron Hands. We just use Clang and Scales again. And then I just use Air Slash onto Weezing. Yeah, they use Fake onto Komo-O. It's fine. Komo-O gets flinched, obviously. We use Air Slash. Weezing goes down. And from here, like, match is basically done. Iron Hands is doing no damage because it's burn. We use Clang and Scales here. We use Air Slash. And yeah, I think they forfeit here, actually. Yeah. Okay, next match. Okay, over here, our opponent sends out, yeah, Dondozo and Drifloon. I was so baffled when I saw this because they didn't have Tatsugiri on their team. This is Dondozo without Tatsugiri, along with Drifloon. I didn't know what to even expect here. So first things first, I used Taunt onto Drifloon because Drifloon's probably gonna use Minimiles, or like, I don't even know what's gonna use, but just like something annoying. And then yeah, we use Nasty Plot with Moltres. So yeah, that's Taunt. And I think it tries to use like Strength Sap. I think it was Strength Sap anyway. Yeah, it probably thought that my Tiny Flame was a physical attacker, but it's not. Dondozo uses Avalanche, does decent damage to Moltres. Over here, we just use Will-O-Wisp onto Dondozo, and we just Terror, and we use Fiery Wrath, basically. Dondozo does have Unaware, so there's that, but Tatsugiri isn't here. So like, Dondozo isn't a threat at all, and I don't know why it's even in the match, but here it is. They swap out Drifloon into Chansey. Okay, we Terror Moltres into Terror Poison. Will-O-Wisp doesn't miss Dondozo, luckily. And yeah, we use Fiery Wrath here. Doesn't do too much to Dondozo or Chansey, but damage is damage at the end of the day. Dondozo uses Avalanche and does like... it does nothing to Moltres. Like, again, I don't know why Dondozo is here. I don't know. But it is, apparently. Over here, we use Taunt onto Chansey. And we just use Fiery Wrath again, just for damage. So yeah, there's Taunt. Fiery Wrath. Basically does like nothing to Dondozo. Again, it does have Unaware. And Chansey does have a lot of special defense, naturally. It uses Seismic Toss onto Moltres. And Berserk activates. So now we're like, what? Plus 3 special attack with Moltres, which is really good. Dondozo did get flinched as well, so there's that. Over here, I just use Heat Wave, and I use Fiery Wrath with Moltres just for damage again. Heat Wave doesn't do a lot, but it's still decent. Fiery Wrath as well, and the Dondozo goes down. They are going to go for Tower here. We use Taunt onto it with Tannenflame, and we just use Fiery Wrath here with Moltres. I don't really know what sort of a team my opponent's actually running. Like, I don't know what's going on here. Like, I couldn't tell you what they're like trying to do, but yeah. We use Taunt onto Gothitelle, We use Fire Wrath as well. And it gets obliterated, like completely. Chansey uses Seismic Toss onto Moltres again. We swap out Talonflame into Sinistra because of Hospitality. And we use Fiery Wrath, and they forfeit the match. So yeah, Galarian Moltres is definitely really good. I'm gonna end my commentary here, but this video will contain other matches that I did play throughout my session. So if you wanna see how those turned out, then keep watching the video. But regardless though, I will see you in the next video.